So, good morning children. I'm here with the next video. I hope all of you are fit and fine and taking care of the precautions told by the Health Ministry of India. Okay. Now, see, I have come here with the topic, that is electric field lines. This is also known as electric lines of force. Okay. It's another name is there, that is electric lines of force. Now, what are these electric field lines actually? These electric field lines actually, see, start writing. Okay. Okay. So, it is defined as path traced by a unit positive charge placed in an electric field is called electric field line or electric line of force. Okay, so definition is very simple, but then also I'm going to explain you. Suppose here you have placed a charge capital Q and it has created, suppose this is a positive charge, so it will create its own electric field around it. As it will create its own electric field around it, now suppose you are going to place a unit positive charge over here. You have placed unit positive charge. What this positive charge will do with this unit positive charge? Obviously, it will repel this unit positive charge. As it will repel, so what will happen? The unit positive charge will try to move away, or will start moving. Not try to move away, but will move away. Okay, and it will follow this path. So this path is called electric field line. If you are going to place this unit positive charge here, then again it will move like this. If you are going to place here, then it will move like this. If you are going to place here, it will move like this. If you are going to place here, it will move like this. If you will place here, then it will move like this. Okay. If you will place here, it will move like this. Okay. And if you place here, it will move like this. So, this is the pattern of electric field lines or electric lines of force due to a positive charge. You don't have to consider this. This is the test charge. Okay. That chart we have brought to test it, and these are the electric field lines. Okay. Now, I will draw the electric field lines due to a negative charge also. Okay. For the case of negative charge, if you are keeping unit positive charge over here, what will happen? It will attract that unit positive charge. So this charge will move like this. So this is the path followed by this unit positive charge. So this is the electric field line. If you will place this unit positive charge here, then again it will feel attraction due to this negative charge. So it will move like this. So its path is electric field line. So electric field line for negative charge is like this only. Okay. Okay. Now, suppose you have got a pair of charges, one is positive, one is negative, then what will happen? If you will place unit positive charge here, then what will happen? Obviously, it will repel, so unit positive charge, what will happen? It will move away from it. As it will move away from it, and this will attract this positive charge, so it will reach near the negative charge. So it will follow this path. If you are placing here, then it will repel, so it will try to move in this direction. At the same time, it will attract, so it will follow this path. So, I have drawn these paths. These are the electric field lines, okay, different electric field lines, or I should say the pattern of electric field lines or electric lines of force due to a pair of opposite charges, okay. So, all of you must draw this, okay. See, if there are similar charges, both are positive or both are negative. Suppose here I have taken both are positive, then what will happen? See there. We know that electric field lines used to start from the positive charge. They move away from the positive charge, come out of the positive charge. So they will come out obviously. But here, there will be a repulsion. So what will happen? These lines will be bending like this. Okay. This will bending like this because lines move away from. Because when you are placing a unit positive charge, this will also repel, this will also repel. So it will move like this. So this is the pattern of electric field lines due to a pair of positive charges. If you are having a pair of negative charges, then for case of negative charges, what will happen? If you are placing instead of positive charge, if you are placing negative charge, then only the thing which will change, the direction will change. pattern will remain same, the direction will change. The direction will change, okay? Direction will get inverted, that's all. So arrowhead you have to invert, otherwise everything is fine. Okay, so this is the pattern of electric field lines or electric lines of force due to two negative charges or a pair of negative charges. Now next, suppose we have got a charged body on which the charges, positive charge is distributed uniformly, then you will get lines, electric field lines like this. And listen, remember, this are the parallel electric field lines and they are having equal space between them. So when the electric field lines are parallel to each other and they are equispaced, then they produce uniform electric field. Electric field. Okay. When the lines are parallel to each other and equispaced, then they produce uniform electric field. Uniform electric field means whatever electric field intensity is there at this point P, the same electric field intensity will be there at point Q. And same electric field intensity will be there at point C. Okay. So at all the points in this region, the electric field intensity will be same. That is the meaning of uniform electric field. Okay. The next topic is properties of electric field lines. Okay. So we are going to discuss some properties of electric field lines. First property, it originates from positive charge and terminates to negative charge. This is the first property. Okay. Second property, do not form closed loop. See, because it originates from positive charge, no, and terminates to negative charge, so it cannot form a closed loop. Okay. Because it is discontinued between the charge particles. It doesn't travel inside the charge particle, okay? Because how can a unit positive charge go inside this charge? It cannot go, okay? So, it never forms closed loop. Third, tangent at any point of electric line of force or electric field line, you can say, gives the direction of electric field at that point. Okay. So at any point, suppose this is the electric field line, okay, and you want to find out the direction of electric field at this point, then what you have to do? You have to draw a tangent. Suppose you have drawn tangent, okay, this is the tangent. So, this is the direction of electric field at this point. Suppose this point is A, so at point A, the electric field will have direction this towards this. You may get confused, it will be this side or this side. Remember, this direction will be according to the direction of electric field line. You have to see the arrow which is there in the electric field line, okay? According to that, you have to put the arrow in the tangent and you will get the direction, okay? And suppose you want to find out the direction of electric field at this point B, then again you have to draw a tangent through this point B like this. So, direction of electric field at point B is this. What about the direction of electric field at point C? Again, you have to draw a tangent through point C. So, electric field will be directed along this line, okay? This ray we can say at point C. So in this way you can find out the direction of electric field lines at any point, direction of electric field intensity at any point of the electric field line by drawing the tangent at those points. Okay.